you know, my days in the 70s and 80s, you know, when I was primarily jocking country music. I mean, you know, yes, like David, I've done many different genres of radio, you know, musical formats, but country was the primary one. And it just, it brings me back to the stuff that we played in the 70s, which is what, you know, he'll make everything all right. It just brought me back to what we were doing. And I know that this, you know, seems to be going on and on and on regarding this, but what you have done with bringing back, you know, root country, classic country, cut the syrup with a knife country, call it what you will, is something that so needs to be done, because so many of the younger people today that are into country music, they don't get it. They don't understand what the real stuff is. And so I want to thank you for making this effort to bring back this genre and keep it alive.
Well, thank you. It's funny that you mentioned the younger folks, because I'm seeing a lot of folks gravitate towards our music, because you kind of touched the surface there a little bit. They're kind of curious. Maybe their grandpa or even their dad or mom, maybe a little bit, had some kind of you know, a Waylon Jennings album or something that they can kind of remember on, and so they kind of know a little bit about it, but they're really intrigued because it's so different and it's so real, and I try to put emotion in my music, and I think there's such a need for that emotion to be expressed again in country music. You know, it's great to have fun, but, you know, and have a, you know, a nonchalant kind of song, but people want to feel that emotion that you're singing about, whether it's a heartbreak or whether it's a true love or if it's a good time out there. They want to feel that emotion in that music again. And I really think that's really the reason that I'm kind of getting some gravity going with the music that I got, because I do put emotion in it.
You're absolutely right. Country music is an emotional genre. There's no two ways about it, whether it's, you know, going out with your friends in low places, or whether it's Tammy Wynette crying her heart out because of her divorce, whatever it is, it's a very emotional music. And I guess that's probably what drew me to it, because I can remember as a kid, back in the old days, and we won't go back to how far back that is, but it was just, I was in the country back before it was the cool thing. As a matter of fact, I was in country before it became uncool. So I've been around a little while, but I can remember, well, to be honest with you, okay, I was born prior to the 1950s, and I can remember growing up on my grandfather's farm with, you know, Eddie Arnold and some of the other hits of the day. And so my first taste of music was really in country music. So you can see where I'm coming from there. Before we run out Absolutely. Of time, Richard, I want to give you time. Tell the people how they can find you and your music, how they can contact you if they've got any comments or nice things they want to say.
Well, the best way to find our music and what we're doing is go to richardlynchband.com. Anything and everything you want to know about me, probably more than you ever want to know about me, is on there. But we have all kinds of our brand new music, all our videos, you know, our merchandise, you know, our wonderful conversations with folks around the country. You know, you mentioned a little bit earlier that I was lucky enough to be around some of my heroes. I got a lot of interviews and shows that I've done with my heroes on there. So, yeah, just go to richardlynchband.com, and you can find out what you want to know about Richard Lynch.
And if you can't find it there, Wikipedia has a pretty good cover of your history, too. So,
check it out there. Pretty amazing.
Hey, that's saying you made it, man. Now, before, last thing, before we let you go, I want you to talk to us about this next song we're going to play, Supernaw.
Well, you know, I was a big fan of Doug Supernaw. Doug had some great songs in the early 90s, and he was a major contribution to the country music radio back then. And I was lucky enough to do a show with him back then. Became friends. 20 years goes by, and we haven't seen each other. We got to re-equate again, and got to do a few shows together. And, of course, he got sick and had cancer, and we ultimately lost him. But I wrote a song just for a tribute to a man and his music, because he was really a wonderful man to be around. And his music inspired me so much. And the best part about this song was I actually got to see Doug listen to it. I was there and got to be around him and let him hear the song before he passed away. And so that was really special in the sense that he knows that I put my heartfelt into it. But he was just a big inspiration to me, and I wanted to write the song and let him know how much people truly do love him and his music.
That is special, the fact that you were able to play for him and he was able to hear the song, you know, that you had written for him. And that really, really added a special touch to it. Richard, I want to thank you so much for being here with us, for giving of your time today and sharing your story as well as your music with us. And I want to be sure and tell everyone to get out there and check out My Guitar Drips Country, which, unusual, I haven't heard. John Bon Jovial usually never hears the music that we play on the show because I like to get his gut reaction the first time he hears it. And, of course, we have studio cameras so I can see him and see what his reaction to the new song is. But I've always heard it. This will be something that will be new to me because I haven't heard any tracks from that. But the album is My Guitar Drips Country. The gentleman is Richard Lynch. We thank you, Richard, for coming and joining
us
today.
Richard.
And we'll look forward to you coming back again in the near future. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Richard Lynch with his tribute, Supernova.
My guitar drips country. I wish that line was mine. It came from a conversation a country legend left behind. We've all heard songs about our heroes, how they've all stood proud and tall. Yes, I like Merle, and I like George, and a guy named Supernova. Texas guy who loves country music. He sang his songs from the heart, kept his fans in the palm of his hands. He mentioned a place called Reno, where Lady Luck dealt him a bad hand. But he found his way back to Texas between the Red and the Rio Grande. His country shows would draw thousands. His career was flying high. But life can change in an instant, with no explanation or reason why. No one gets promised tomorrow, and we don't know what hand will draw. Well, you made us proud when you sang loud. Thanks for the music, Supernova. This guy who loves country music. He sang his songs from the heart, kept his fans in the palm of his hands. He mentioned a place called Reno, where Lady Luck dealt him a bad hand. But he found his way back to Texas between the Red and Texas, between the red and the Rio Grande.
Richard Lynch, right here on the David Bowers Awards. Thank you, Richard. Thank you, David. We want to thank both of our guests, Richard Lynch and David Starr, for spending time with us here today and sharing their stories and music with us, as well as you. As I was, as I was telling Richard off mic when he was leaving, one of the things that I really love about doing the show is not only getting to hear the music, but getting to meet and talk with the artists. I've met some of the neatest people through the show, the artists that we've met and had on the show, as well as some great people that we already knew who have come and spent time on our sofa with us. So thank you to all our guests in the past, and looking forward to a lot more in the near future. We've got some great ones coming, so don't you miss out. You should be sure and be here. We keep the show on, it's on file at Blog Talk Radio in their archives, so you can always go back. If you miss a show, you can download it and take it home with you, or come back and listen on Blog Talk Radio. It's always there. Be sure and write us. If you have any questions, comments, compliments, we'll take them too. David at thedavidbowers.com. Drop me a line. Love to hear from you. John Bon Jovial, I think it's time to take us home.
Folks, you did it again. You spent another perfectly good hour with us here at The David Bowers Awards, and we are eternally grateful for it. And we hope, of course, to see you right back here again next week for another exciting edition of The David Bowers Awards, which just happens to be broadcast around the world from the studios of Computer Help USA in Naples, Florida, and, of course, from the Valley of the Sun in Tempe, Arizona. We are available for free on most major streaming services, and, of course, you can follow The David Bowers Awards on Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, and all those other silly social media platforms. And you can also join us next week for the David Bowers Awards, Saturday at 12 p.m. Eastern on WRFC-FM. That's 106.3 Rochester, New York, Rochester Free Radio, and on Blog Talk Radio, Sunday, 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific, and 7 p.m. UTC. So until next week, for the David Bowers and Nick, our incredibly, marvelously geeky engineer, I am yours truly, the lovably, legendary John Bon Jovial, saying wash your hands, keep your distance, love one another. We'll see you next week right here on the David Bowers Awards.